Good evening, welcome to My Point of View. My Point of View is a video blog that deals with activities and events as they occur in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. We will be right back.
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Good day again. Welcome back to My Point of View. Now, St. Vincent is a community of individual families and organization. And each individual family and organization has an obligation to the community to ensure that a standard of ethics, a standard of morality, a standard of justice is being practiced within that community. Because if this does not happen, it affects not one person, not one organization, not one family, but it affects all family in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. For example, a politician has a political, a moral, and an ethical obligation to the people to confront evil, especially evil that happens within the scope of government. Ministers of religion has a moral and a spiritual obligation to the people and to God to ensure that they confront evil when it occurs within the society, especially evil that occurs in position and places of authority. We have those people who are involved in the media, whether you're a trained journalist, just a regular talk show host or not. You have an obligation to confront evil wherever it happens. You have an obligation as a journalist, as a person in the media, your ethical responsibility is to uncover evil, corruption, unlawful practices and behaviors, especially when they are done by folks of authority or people holding position of authority. But it seems to me that each time a bold confrontation is to be made, it is done by one person within St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And that person is Ashford Peters. Now, Ashford have been confronting Ralph on several topics of national importance, several topics of moral importance, several topics of political importance, several topics of ethical importance. He have become an enigma in the sight of Ralph Gonsalves, where every time he show up to a press conference, Ralph Gonsalves look at him with strange eyes and is very nasty and rude towards him. Now, last week in New York City in a town hall meeting, a young lady by the name of Miranda Woods, an ambassador of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, because she have represented St. Vincent and the Grenadines on the national level in netball, in the sporting arena. Netball ambassador Miranda Woods came forward and accused the Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines of sexually assaulting her in his office when she was 15 years old. It made a few headlines, but that was it.
Fire! 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 Fire!
This is a sexual allegation by the person who holds the highest political office in the land. That make this allegation not only a criminal allegation, but it also is a political allegation. And the political opposition is supposed to jump on this like a hawk going after a rat. But for reason unknown to me, they have not taken it up. They have not sprung on it. They have not even tried to hold the Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines accountable for the allegations, or get a lawful answer from him. In a press conference, Ashford Peters took it upon himself, in his capacity as a journalist and in his capacity as Honest Vincentian, to hold the Prime Minister by asking him about what happened in New York and if he have any statement to give.
Next question, Prime Minister. In 2008, when a member of your security detail accused you of a sexual offense, you issued a statement on one hand putting yourself at the scene of the alleged crime. But on the other hand, too, you denied the allegation and you said, well, it was merely a reassuring hug that you had given her. Now, almost 2 weeks ago, a former netballer, accused you of sexually assaulting her. You did not respond much to her at that meeting in the town hall. Well, she did say that, but on a subsequent program, she did say you sexually assaulted her. Now, why haven't you really been so given so much explanation as you did in the first? That is the third public allegation against you.
You know, none of you say those things. But the point is this I'm making. You're not going to get me into these kinds of commentaries. So you can pose your question, you can make all the comments you want on them. I have said what I have to say, and that's that.
But Prime Minister, you have been labeled as a sex predator, and this is the third
point about it.
Ashford Peters coined his question so well that Ralph Gonsalves did not have a wiggle room to wiggle out of it. But what he did, he started a witch hunt narrative.
If you want to get a song bite for the radio, or you want to get something for your newspaper, I just answered you. What I would allow you to do now, when you finish with that, and you finish with your monologue, I will just move on. So you can go ahead, make all the allegations, who say what, and I will say.
I'm not making any allegation. I'm merely questioning you on allegations made publicly against you, Prime Minister. You are the Prime Minister.
Now, a witch hunt narrative, it's another way of evading the reality of the situation that confronts one. So Ralph Gonsalves' favorite witch hunt narrative is the person was set up by the NDP. Now, the witch hunt narrative that he used to deflect or to show little importance to Ashford Peters' question was,
if you want to get a song bite for the radio, or you want to get something for your newspaper, I just answered you. What I would allow you to do now, when you finish with that, and you finish with your monologue, I will just move on.
Ashford is trying to get a media soundbite, or he's trying to get a headlines for his newspaper. He refused to acknowledge the fact that because this young lady make a sexual allegation against him, that Ashford Peters' question was relevant, it was timely, and it was necessary. He has an obligation as Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines to answer Ashford Peters' question. Well, the fact is that Ralph Gonsalves had molested, raped, and sexually assaulted so many people that he have lost track of the people who he have so assaulted and so molested and so raped.
Fire.
Now the second thing is that Prime Minister Ralph Gonsalves is spearheading a bungalow project in Bekri. You know what I smell? I smell citizenship by investment. This is supposed to be a high class investment in Bekri. Now, it is not a hotel, it is residence, and these residence will be for so-called the rich and the famous. Now, I smell citizenship by investment. This is not good. I will tell you this, if you think Kanawan is having trouble, wait until this project get on stream. With Ralph Gonsalves' dirty hand involved, Kanawan trouble will be a walk in the park compared to what is going to happen in Bekri. He also going to start the Mount Twin Hotel. You think David Ames was trouble? You think Kanawan is trouble? Wait until these two projects get on stream. You will see trouble. Vincentian would have more trouble than the Caribs and the Garifuna people had with the British. I am telling you, these people are evil, these people are nasty, these people are dirty, and they are looking to invest in countries that have naive government and a naive citizenry who they can manipulate and take advantage of. We are going to have more trouble with these, and as a matter of fact, these two projects are going to be stained with death. Locals who are involved in these projects are going to die before the completion of these projects. Mark my word. Now let's get on to David Ames. It is said that David Ames stole about $7 million in taxes and INS money from the government and citizens and the Grenadines. But you have to remember that David Ames' company is a corporation. If this corporation failed to pay the money and the CEO stole the money and ran away, the CEO is not liable to St. Vincent except for answering criminal charges. This corporation is still outstanding with the money that should have been paid into the government coffers. So the $7+ million is still owed by this corporation. Don't let 12 guns fool you. The corporation is still liable for this debt. And if this debt is have surpassed the value of the corporation asset, then it is in the government interest. It is in the people's interest that the government go in and acquire this company, of course, using the lawful channels. Taking the company to court and getting a judgment for the amount, and therefore taking possession of the company, because the $7 million have to be paid by the company. David Ames does not owe the people and the government of St. Vincent and Grenadines $7 million. The company that he manages owe the people and the government of St. Vincent and Grenadines $7 million. So if he stole that money from the company and run away, that is the company loss. The company have to write that off as a loss, but they are still indebted to the government of $7 million. So Ralph Gonsalves, go do your homework. You are a lawyer, you're supposed to know these things. So I am looking forward for action coming against the company, because this corporation, this company, is an entity by itself. Is not an entity associated with David Ames. David Ames is an individual who owns that entity and manages that entity. But whatever asset David Ames has is not associated with this company because of the incorporation laws of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. So Mr. Gonsalves, do your work. Colin Williams is supposed to be a lawyer. He's supposed to be the director of public prosecution. You are supposed to be prosecuting matters on behalf of the state, of the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Do your job. Attorney General Morgan, you say you have this big law degree and you're Attorney General for almost 17 years. Do your job. It's my guy, Papa, This is Alan Palmer, and I'm saying, until we see again on My Point of View. Judgment morning, I'm at the gate and I'm waiting. God, I'm begging the master, but give me a walk with Peter. Because some sinners coming, with them I go be dealing. Because the things that they do me, I'm going to fix them personally.